Now, while getting married, we all have this perception that the only job that we need to do after being married is to go ahead, be ready and look presentable for all the family members. Let me tell you guys, this is a myth. Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you all this makeup look right here using just 5 products which are quite essential enough for your wedding trousseau. And trust me on this thing, apart from this, you won't have any other time to do anything else, because 99.99% of ways we are given just 15 to 20 minutes to get ready for some place, and we don't even know what place we are supposed to go. It's just we need to get ready. So I'm gonna share with you all my essentials and this makeup look, and it's just a tip on how you can look presentable within 10 to 15 minutes, because in those 10 to 15 minutes you are supposed to drape the sari as well as do your makeup. So I hope you all will enjoy today's video. If you people do, go ahead and give this video a massive thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you people haven't already. Let's get started. The first thing, which is your best friend, like literally it's going to be proven as your best friend, is your concealer. You can skip your foundation, but you can never skip on your concealer. It's that important, guys. Here I have used the LA Girl Pro HD Concealer and I've just applied it all around the eye. One thing that you need to make sure is whenever you're assembling your bridal trousseau, just go ahead and buy a concealer which is full coverage, guys, and it has a matte finish, because in today's video I'm not gonna set my concealer with the help of a setting powder. So you need to have a matte concealer. So here you can see I'm first of all I went ahead with just the under eye area, and then on the second layer I'm just gonna go ahead and apply it once again under the eye area to give it that full coverage sort of a look. And apart from that, I've just applied it to the higher points of my face and I'm just blending it all out with the help of my damp miracle sponge. And after that, I'll be using a dry miracle sponge to just set it all out, because I'm not going to use any compact powder over here. So it will take just a few moments and you'll look presentable. Coming up to the second product, I'm using this Master Contour Kit. You can use any contour kit which has the blusher and the bronzer and the highlighter for you. One more recommendation: if you have to choose between bronzing and contouring, go ahead for bronzing, because it's a lot less time consuming. It's really easy to blend compared to contouring. Contouring takes a lot of time. So here you can see I've just went ahead and applied my bronzer, my blusher, and I'm just gonna go ahead and apply my highlighter with the same palette. I don't have to swap up all around my vanity to take out distinct products for myself. And here you can see I have just completed my face base makeup. For eyeliner, I'd rather recommend you to go ahead with the gel one, as it will just help you out to apply it on your lower lash line as well as on your upper lash line. So here you can see me, I'm just lining my eyes. I've just applied that bronzer all over my eyelid to give them a little bit of a natural look along with a little bit of depth that I did wanted them to have. So here you can see me, I'm just going ahead and grooming my eyes. Now, because you don't have anything intricate to do, go ahead with a cat eyeliner if you have practiced that. And even if you have not, try to give it as your best, like literally. Eyeliner is going to change your game. So here you can see I'm just tight lining my eye with the help of the same. Now, mascara is really very important. Try and choose a waterproof mascara. As here you can see, I'm just going to go ahead and groom my lashes. This is the product number 4, guys, and I haven't switched up to my brows yet. So you can imagine completely, I guess, that I am going to use my mascara for grooming up my brows as well. And this is going to be proven so effective. Like, this is something that you'd cherish. Like, literally, you'll thank me for this hack. As you're going to see the side-by-side difference I'm going to show you. Here you can see me, I'm just grooming my brows after applying the mascara onto the lashes. So don't do this like directly dipping the wand into the mascara and then applying it onto the brows directly. It will be like way too much and it will get messy and you won't be able to control the amount. So first apply it onto your lashes and then go ahead and groom your brows with the help of it, with the rest of the product that is left onto the mascara wand. So that's how. Here you can see the difference between the done eyebrows and the undone one. So here you can see me, now I'm gonna go ahead and apply it onto my lower lash line, or my lower lashes of course. This would just give my eyes a brighter and an opener look. So here you can see I am just gonna go ahead, and this will eliminate the need of applying kohl pencil onto the waterline as well. For lipstick, go ahead with the boldest shade you have, because it's just going to go ahead and brighten up each and every single thing on your face. And try and make sure that the longevity is there, and if it is kiss proof, it's even more beneficial for you. I guess you people understand what I am trying to say, but undeniably neither of the ways. Here you can see the product number 5 is my lipstick. This one is by Huda Beauty, and I am using the shade called Heartbreaker. And with that, I finished this makeup look using just 5 products and looking presentable for any of the events that is coming across. So I hope you all have enjoyed, and if you people did, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Bye bye.